So, dear students, today we'll get an introduction of signal flow graphs. So, what is a signal flow graph? How you can understand or describe the signal, or what is the flow of your signal? So, in outline, we will study introduction to signal flow graphs, its some definitions, some terminologies, and one example. So, now introduction. So, alternative method to block diagram representation developed by Samuel Jeffron Mason. So, Mason developed the method of signal flow graph, which is an alternative method to a block diagram representation. So, the advantages, the basic advantage is the availability of flow graph gain formula, also called as Mason's gain formula. So, this we will study in next lecture. So, our point of interest is to introduction of signal flow graph. A signal flow graph consists of a network in which nodes are connected by directed branches. So what are nodes, what are branches, we will study in next slide. So it depicts the flow of signal from one point of a system to another and gives the relationships among the signal. Means the signal moves from one point, one node to another node. Here you can see a fundamental of the signal flow graph is a simple equation you can study is y is equal to ax. So your a is your signal flow graph equation, and y is your end node and x is your starting node. So every variable in a signal flow graph is designed by a node. Okay, every transmission function in a signal flow graph is designed by a branch. So your a stands for as a branch. So branches are always unidirectional. The arrow in the branch denotes the direction of the signal. Once again, I repeat, every variable in a signal flow graph is designed by a node. Okay. And every transmission function in a signal flow graph is designed by a branch. Next, we will move on. Signal flow graph model, just to get through. Y1 of s is equal to G1 of s into R of s plus G12 of s into R of s. So here you can see R1 of x and Y1 of s, so G11 of s. So here you can multiply like G11 of s into R1 of s is equal to Y1 of s. Same we have done in this y is equal to ax. Okay, so this is a signal flow graph model in Y2. Y1 and Y2 are your output, and this is your branch G11 and G12, 22 are the signal systems. Okay. Now, signal flow graph models R1 and R2 are the inputs and X1 and X2 are the outputs. So, here you can give A11 X1 plus A12 X2 R1 is equal to X1. Okay. So, here you can understand the system by R1 and R2 are the inputs and X1 and X2 are your output. So, the loop moving towards A11 into X1 and A22 into X2. Now, a signal flow graph model X0, X0 is your input and X4 is your output. So, you can study by X1 is equal to AX0 plus BX1 plus CX2. Here you can understand the signal that is moving. So, what is X2? X2 is moving towards BX1 plus EX3. Okay, X2 is equal to DX1 plus EX3, and X3 is for FX0 plus GX2. So this is a signal flow graph. Now constructing a signal flow graph for the following set of simultaneous equations. So X2 is your final output. Here you can see. So A21 X1 plus A23 X3. So A21 and A23 are the signals moving, and X1 and X3, these are your so you can say it as a nodes. So these are construction of signal flow graph from your equation. Now there is terminology. In the figure you can see an input node is your X1, output node is your X4. So the path is a continuous unidirectional succession of branches. So these are the branches X2, X3. These are the branches which are moving, having a signal A21, A32. So forward path is from the input node to the output node. So the forward path is from X1 to X2 to X3 to X4, X1 to X2 to X4. Number of paths which are moving from X1 to X2. Feedback path is, you can say X3 is your feedback loop, so which originates and terminates on the same node. So the same node is x2 to x3, back to x2 is feedback. So this is your x1 to x2 to x4. Here you can see now again x2 to x3 to x4. Now again you can see x2 to x3 to x4, and again x1 to x4, and again x1, x2, x4. So these are your forward paths, and these are, this is, you can see x2, x3 and x4. Now the terminologies, you can see a self loop is a feedback loop, that is an A33. You are having a self loop. Now, gain of branch is a transmission function of that branch. Okay. The path gain of the product is x1, x2, x3, x3, x4. Okay. This is your self loop. Now, this is a total unidirectional path. And this is x2, x3, x4. You can say feedback. So consider the signal flow graph below and identify the following. Now, this is your signal flow graph from RS to CFS. GFS is your system, HFS is your feedback, you can say. Number one is a input node, output node, forward path, feedback path, determine loop gains of the feedback loops, determine the non-touching loop, and finally non-touching loops. So there are two forward path gains. So here you can see from RS to S, this is one forward path moving from G1, G2, G3, G4, G5, G7. This is your forward path. Number two is, second is from G1, G2, G3, G4, again G6 and G7. So there are two paths from input to output. Now there are four loops, as figure you can see 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is one, this is two, this is your third loop, and this is your fourth loop. Now, non-touching loops are loops which are non-touching each other, is number one G2 H1 of S into G4 and H2 of S. So this is your non-touching loop. Second non-touching loop is G2 H1 of S, G4, G5 and H3. Number third is from G2, H1 of S, G4, G6, H3. So these are your non-touching loops. Hence, we have studied all this. Next, we will cover in next lecture. So, thank you.